Anderson.
Well, you said, no, no, not us, but the...
All right, good evening, everyone. Welcome to our East Campus. The last time we got a chance to check in with each other, our freshman information night was over at Main Campus. So welcome to East Campus. Provides us a little bit of flexibility. We are streaming tonight's event to families that couldn't make it, or if you got somebody that you want to rewatch, or you got questions, you're good to go, or don't catch a name, you'll be able to pull this up on our website and be able to go from there. So for those of you that I haven't had the opportunity to meet, I'm Jason, I'm the principal, and I'm excited you could be here tonight because this is our second step in the journey, right? Step one was the freshman information night, you watched the live stream, you came and checked things out, right? And you're starting to think a little bit about yourself as a raccoon. And whether you're coming from Silver Lake, Nature Hill, I know we have a few families coming from different area schools, right? You're starting to begin that journey. And you did your course requests, and while you may have thought there was a tough decision between Accelerated English 9 and English 9, right? The decisions only get tougher. And we're here along the journey with you to help you explore who you are and figure out where it is that you want to go. So we talk about our three core values all the time, and hopefully you know them by now, but I won't quiz you, right? We're grounded, committed, and accountable as raccoons. And grounded means that we're figuring out who we are. Doesn't mean that things don't change, but the reality is we're on a journey to identify our passion and goals. And you've been doing that for the last 8 years as you entered into high school. You're not going to walk into Oconomowoc High School on September 1st and be a whole new student, a whole new learner, whole new interest group, right? Things are going to get firmed up a little bit, but you're not going to transform necessarily who you are. You're figuring out who you are right now. You like band. You want to continue with it, so you signed up. Or maybe you stopped doing band or choir for the first time in maybe 4 years, and you made that decision, right? But one thing we do know about, I think almost all of you in this room, is that you do have a desire to go to a four-year college. And we talk about figuring out who we are, right? We talk about the next step of, we set some goals, right? I want to be an engineer. Maybe your dad's an engineer, and you want to do that. Maybe you want to be a pilot. Maybe you want to go to Madison because it just looks cool to sit in the student section. Maybe you want to be a teacher and you need to go to college, right? As you become grounded in who you are and you make some of those key life decisions, the next step in our values is to commit to them, right? And you don't commit to becoming a teacher or to being an engineer or going to Madison, right, by just going through the motions. Everybody at Oconomowoc High School will walk out of here with a diploma and a plan, and we're ready to support them in that. You have indicated that you have a strong desire or a desire to go to a four-year college. And we're here to help you commit to that. So AVID is one of our programs designed to help students who have identified four-year college as their pathway to post-secondary readiness. And like I said, not everybody's ready for college or you'd be there already, right? We all have skills and deficits that we can improve upon as we continue down this journey. And we're so excited in the last year to bring in AVID and bringing it in with the challenges that have been this year have been hard for us, but also to help our raccoons commit. The word that goes along with committed is sacrifice, right? When you decide to commit to a goal, there's other things you're going to have to sacrifice. And there's a little bit of a yin and a yang that comes with that. AVID is a program you're going to learn about tonight about how these raccoons have committed to, I want to go to a four-year college, so I'm willing to sacrifice a study hall so that I can come into a room and get tips on taking notes and applying writing skills within my content area, right? I'm willing to sacrifice what might be a pride period or two to come in and think about a little bit about ACT prep work and those types of things. And it's a four-year journey designed to help support you on that goal to become whatever you want to be at a four-year school. So AVID is a program that's designed for a very specific group of people ready to go. And it's not for everybody either. So as you go through the next hour and you hear a little bit about the freshmen that are in it now and their journey, you hear from some of our teachers and advisors and how they support along the journey, I think I would just ask you to kind of reflect on two things as you go through it. A, how you think this might help you be more prepared for college. And then B, and this is a hard one, what are your deficits as a learner, right? And as you think about your kids, do we struggle with organization? Right? Do we struggle with maybe writing? Do we struggle with taking notes, right? And how can we help you become a little bit stronger academically so that you can be successful in college and gain those skills now? I do like when I said some of those deficits, there are a lot of eye rolls and staring at kids. So that was good. That was good. We're in the right place. And you'll get to hear from them directly. So I'm proud to introduce our team to you tonight. Our director is Ms. Regan, and she's here. And then I'll let her kind of take it from there. So welcome, and we'll be around if you have any questions, and enjoy the night.
Good evening, and thank you so much for coming. Some of you I've been in contact with via email, and I really appreciate making the trek, even though it's a beautiful night, right? It's a nice day to get out. So I'm going to start with what AVID stands for, and I'm going to introduce some of the other people that we have and our student section that you see. I'm Jamie Regan. I'm the district director and the AVID Elective 9 teacher. We have Angie Laurier, our Elective 10 teacher. Susan Verhagen is an AVID counselor, but she's also just a counselor in our counseling department. Back in the corner, we have Melissa Anders, who is a AP as well as the coordinator for the AVID program. And then I'm going to let the kids introduce. Okay? Look at, they're all so scared. Come on over.
Okay, I'll hold it. I'm Olivia Utek, and I'm... I'm a level 9 AVID student, freshman. Yep.
Thank you.
I'm Miranda Sandholm, AVID 9 elective student.
I'm Carson Ukenna, and I'm an AVID 9 elective student.
I'm Jack Ketty. I'm an AVID 9 student.
We put all the freshmen over here. Here we got a little variety.
I'm a freshman.
Yeah, you are. I know. We have a little variety.
Okay.
No, you're good.
Okay. I'm Ruby Bloom, and I'm an AVID 9 freshman.
I'm Michaela Trioni, and I'm an AVID 10 student.
Good. Sophomore.
Yep. I'm Lisa Hernandez, and I'm an AVID 11 student.
Very good. So as you can see, we started implementing the program this year, but we do have three levels. Our AVID 11s are a little smaller, but we have quite a few freshmen and sophomores in the program. So I'll start with kind of just giving you an overview of what AVID is, and then they will kind of fill in some gaps and give you some real life experience, because really that's what's going to mean most to your student sitting there, is to hear from the kids what it is the program can offer. So as Mr. Curtis said, AVID's purpose is, it is a college prep program. So it is for, it's building skills necessary for success throughout college. So it isn't this program to get you into school, because we know you can get there. It's, can you survive through those 4 years and really be successful through the 4 years of college? So it's different in that mentality in terms of what it can do for you. It supports students through challenging high school coursework and gives them, again, those skills with rigorous coursework. So we push after probably the sophomore year for all students to be involved in an AP or an IB course. Again, that's where the rigor comes from. So how does AVID help students? And this is where some of you guys are going to jump in, right? It teaches study note-taking and organizational skills. So that's exactly what Mr. Curtis said, right? When you think about what and where your deficits are, what could you use some more work on? Is it organization? Is it that you've never really been taught note-taking skills? Because that is something that we focus on quite a bit. Would you agree? Especially in the foundational years, right? And so realistically, even though Lisa is a junior, she's still building the foundation that AVID kind of it entails. That they still all need to learn the basics of note-taking and organization, because there's very specific ways that AVID puts that together, and that's where the research base is. It strengthens reading and writing skills. So the curriculum for each of the years is actually very tailored to where a student's needs are at that time. So what they've seen is that the freshman year, the curriculum is more based around reading skills and building and strengthening those skills. So we're gonna have some, again, individuals talk about that. But just so you kind of understand that each year it is tailored to a different skill. Sophomore year is very much about writing skills and building that college readiness in terms of writing. By junior year, the focus becomes a little bit more ACT, college research, and really a focus on finding where you want to be and what does that look like after. And then senior year, we talk about scholarships, FAFSA, a lot of things that other kids aren't going to get in classes, but here that would all be built in. So putting together letters of recommendation and everything that entails that senior year This follows and helps those students with that in a class versus having to do it outside. And then teaches students to work collaboratively to be successful in the most rigorous courses. So the collaboration piece is through tutorials, which we'll explain shortly. Because again, that was a big learning curve, wasn't it? In terms of, like, I've never really done this before. So you can hear from their voice on that. And then a sense of hope and personal achievement. So as AVID is, it's about individual determination. And so we see that when kids want it, they're totally capable of that success. And that's what's really going to push them to want to achieve in harder classes, right? And that's where the rigor and that push comes from. And so that piece we like to build by pushing the positive and showing kids that you can do it. You don't have to do it today, but we'll get there by the end. And that's what AVID helps to support. Michaela, do you want to talk about a little bit about your experience and like things that, like, you know, what? How do you feel like it helped you?
There you go. So I need a lot of help on my organization, and so far we've been really focusing on the notes, which do help you when you go back to it in the classes. And another thing that comes to organization is our binders. Those are really nice to keep all your classes in order.
Did anyone else want to add how AVID's helped them? Olivia, maybe you can speak to it, or Miranda? Miranda, come on.
Okay, so at the start, I didn't think it would help, like, at all. I was like, no way, like, I don't think this is going to be, like, worth my time. But then, like, the second quarter came around, and, like, I looked into it more and was like, whoa, this, like, actually is going to help. And all the notes definitely helped a lot, because when it came down to, like, tests and stuff, you could look back on all the notes that were actually helpful, because some notes you do in your normal classes don't like help as much. They normally just put words on the screen and you just copy them. But for this one, you have to like go back through your notes and look back to see what you wrote down and think about it again, which helps to remember like for tests.
All right, and then we'll move on to, again, some more of the, which you may be questioning, right? Is my son or daughter right for this program? So AVID, as a national program, has a certain profile that students have to fit. And we have worked really hard to make sure that we get the right kids in the program so that it's benefiting the ones that really need it the most. And so this is just a little bit of the framework that we used and how we tried to adjust things a little bit this year. So it is for that middle group, right? Because we already have programs in line for our high achievers, and we also have programs in line for those that need additional academic support on the other end of that. But really, this group in the middle just sometimes gets passed up. And so you may be saying, well, I have A's right now. That may be true, but do you have all of the skills necessary for a four-year college? And that's really where you kind of want to, right? We have to balance those things too when we're making sure that we're getting the right kids. So we look at all of these things up here in terms of just what do you comprise as a whole student? So it's grades, it's behavior, the requiring daily homework monitoring. Some of you may be saying, oh my goodness, I do that quite a bit. I'm always, right? Or you might say, no, I'm totally hands off. And both of those students could benefit from being an AVID, because I think you might agree that some of the changes in the beginning, like a planner, right, felt kind of odd, right? And we made some adjustments at semester to like going to phone planners and things like that. But just having that, writing what you have down, becomes so much more a life skill than it just does a school skill, right? We all kind of have a way, whether it's a calendar on a desk at home, or a Google Calendars, or some way that we keep track of where we're supposed to be. And that's one of those life skills that we're trying to teach kids. And then we also look at MAP scores. And this year, we added an additional layer in terms of Lexile. We wanted the Lexile, which would be your reading level, to be at or above a 1,000, so that you were reading about at class level, so a freshman or just about below a freshman reading level. Avid is not. Why do you laugh? Yeah, they're laughing because I purposely went in and put in bullet number two after talking to these kids because that was what they said. They said, oh my gosh, I thought this was going to be an easy A. And I keep saying, right, if we're building things that you didn't have, that shouldn't be an easy way. It shouldn't be easy, right? It takes work to build new character, build new ways, build new habits. And so that's kind of, I think, what was part of the rude awakening there. But I do really want to stress this and that you understand that it isn't a free ride. It's not a study hall. And so we had some misconceptions, I think, out there with our current kids that they really, and their parents too, thought that this was going to be just a guided study hall of some sort and that they would be working on classwork in this. It isn't. It has its own curriculum. AVID does. And so we base what we do on that curriculum. So it isn't just, you know, a willy-nilly kind of study hall, but we help them. We work on real things. And would you agree that I don't really allow too much free time? We work, don't we? Yeah, we do. Yeah. A quick fix, it's not special education. It isn't for at-risk, or it is not an intervention. So some of those things and that misconception or those preceptions that are out there, I just want to make sure that you really fully understand that it is not any of these things. All right, why? I don't know if we have to push it there. You are going to be in this. You are? Yeah. I think we can go to, oh, you can do it. But can you make it big? Thank you.
Out of the many different programs located at OHS, AVID stands as one of our greatest, especially for those students who want to start pushing themselves into college readiness. And what exactly do our students have to say about this?
AVID has helped me by taking better focus notes and really understanding what I'm learning in all my classes.
AVID has helped me specifically in math. I bring all my questions to tutorials and then I get help from my peers and my teacher and understand it, and then I can bring it back and I can help more and like participate more in my math class.
AVID's helped me to stay organized with my binder, and all my notes also help me with my tests.
Now, how do students use their binders?
In AVID, we have our binder, which sections off each of our classes with tabs so that we can stay as organized as possible. Each tab includes focus note paper so that we optimize our note taking and learn as much as we can from our classes.
When I first joined AVID, I thought that I was organized, but then when we had to start using these binders, it really got me in check and I'm more organized now.
Another amazing aspect to the AVID program are the tutorials that students participate in. This is where students have a particular problem within a subject that needs to be solved. Everyone in the class will then help that student out.
Two times a week, we do tutorials. This is a tutorial request form that we fill out prior to the tutorial.
Tutorials are really good in helping me connect with my classmates and help me figure out answers that I don't understand.
Another cool aspect to AVID is that fellow students can also opt in to tutor.
So I just became an AVID tutor, and the first thing I noticed is I just think it's super cool how everybody is able to go up and present their questions, and everybody, their fellow peers, are able to help them generate answers to those questions, and they're able all to collaborate with one another and figure out the answers.
All in all, the AVID program is highly beneficial to all those who enroll in it. In fact, the only cost to you is the time it takes to submit an application and complete an interview.
AVID, fail to succeed!
Okay, so as I said, right, AVID, the premise of AVID is built on five kind of characteristics or things that they focus on. And WICR is the acronym that AVID chooses to use, which stands for writing, inquiry, collaboration, organization and reading. And so we're going to go through some of the things that we do. And I said, as I said, sophomore year really focuses a lot more on writing. But within every of the year or every year, kids do all of these types of things, whether it is ACT prep that is built in. Even as freshmen, we've started working on some of those things, the note taking and quick writes. So what I did was I took actually Olivia's her quick write about success and what it means, because that was just one of the weekly quick writes. So we just do these things that only take 5 minutes, but it's getting kids to write when they otherwise wouldn't. Another nice part about AVID and being part of the program is that it allows for a year-long emphasis on reading and writing for all of your years versus maybe just having it second semester or an English class. So again, some of the things that you should think about in terms of what could actually be the perks behind a class like this that's a year-long skinny versus just a semester-long black class. Olivia, will you talk to us about writing? Thanks.
Okay, so we do a lot of writing in AVID class when it comes to like the once a week quick writes like this, which is nice because it's not always about like, how are your grades doing? It's like, how do you think you can be successful, or how does setting goals help you? And that's what these quick writes are. And then there's also, in your notes, when you take your focus notes, you have your summary. And your summary is nice because you get to put everything in one spot and you get to explain your thoughts. And so when writing in AVID, you really get to like know what you're supposed to put. And then when you know what you want to put in your writing, it's good to help you like lay out your thoughts. So, yeah.
Yeah, and Olivia was talking about focus notes, so it is the Cornell style. And I don't know about any of you, but I was never taught in high school or middle school how to take notes. Was it? Like, is that right? Can you kind of maybe agree, right, that that isn't a skill that kids are actually taught? Teachers often assume and say, take out your notebooks, you're going to take notes. And then kids furiously, right, scribble down everything that the teacher either puts up on a screen or is trying, you know, they're trying to copy what they say. But then they never go back and actually use those pieces of information that they just copied down to actually benefit them in terms of preparing for a test or a quiz, or now in our case, exams. Inquiry is all about asking questions. Ms. Laurier, would you like to step up and tell us a little bit, just a basis of how we use CASTA's levels of thinking? I thought so. They want to hear from other people.
I don't think they want to hear from me. Yeah,
you're
no. I'm going to turn red in 10 seconds, and Mr. Curtis is going to make fun of me. But that's okay. That just happens. Okay, sure. Thank you. When we talk more about tutorials, right, we're going to talk more about tutorials in a little bit, because that's really kind of where our inquiry comes in, asking good questions instead of looking at something and learning something and going, I don't get it. You asking better questions like what don't I understand? At what point am I missing key information? Getting beyond level one questions, just the who, what, when, where, why, and really digging in and asking deeper questions. And so AVID uses CASTA's levels of questioning. Level one is just your basic. Level two, you can see, is processing and starting to apply that information. And then level three is beyond. So we are getting better about asking good questions and knowing how to ask questions and dig into their content instead of just being able to say, you know, like what is the definition of something, but then once you know the definition of something, how to use it and apply it in classes.
All right, gentlemen, you ready? Yep. Oh, look at that. I love it. I love it. Can you talk to us a little bit about tutorials? Because people are sitting here going, I don't know what that means. I don't know what that is. So kind of explain the passage.
Yeah. All right. So each class is separated into like two or three, depending on the size of the class, tutorial groups. And there are like about like five or six people. You each beforehand fill out TRFs, which is you go to your academic class and you figure out something you're kind of confused about or don't really know. And then you write that and you fill out a TRF, which has like your initial question and then all your thinking on your questions and then your final like tutorial question is what we call it. And then you can talk about actual tutorials.
All right, so during the tutorial, a lot of it is based on like the level 2 and level 3 talking and like questioning other people's things. Like sometimes like I find it easy for like math ones because a lot of it's like leading to the next step, but then like sometimes it's hard to do it with like something like biology because that is a lot of memorizing and that kind of stuff. Sometimes like it's hard to find actual questions to bring to a tutorial. Like it's hard to think of something like if you aren't struggling in any classes and you really don't like know something that you can like bring and like actually will benefit from, like sometimes you can do it as a review, like asking questions, and those questions you may already know like half the answer to or like have a decent understanding of it, but you can almost use that as just like a chance to see other people's ways of solving it or other people's opinions. Can I like say one more thing? Okay. All right, thanks. The last thing is like, for me, that's really a struggle, like trying to find a question. Cause like sometimes there are like some classes where I struggle in, but it's like, just like, it's not really about the content understanding. And sometimes it might just be as simple as like me and the teacher not really like clicking and me not being able to just learn as much from that teacher. So then sometimes for a class that I'm like better in, you can do a point of excellence instead of a point of confusion. So then it's almost more like you're teaching the rest of your group. Like for me, I did one on math because that's one of the classes that I'm a lot better in. And for math, it was almost like if someone else in that group has a struggle with math, you could kind of use that to lead them and almost have them like help you walk through it, even though a lot of it is you more trying to get them to an answer, and it's a lot more about using your knowledge to help the other people in the group.
All right, so yeah, Avid is pretty much every Tuesday and Thursday. I don't know if that'll change, but we do tutorials. So that's pretty much the kind of one of the main ideas of Avid. And the idea of the tutorials is you don't just tell the person doesn't ask their question, and then completely the other people just answer it. The other people have to ask level 2 or 3 questions to help the person figure it out. You're not allowed to just answer their question as they like ask it. You have to ask questions so they can figure it out on their own.
Wait, one thing. How do you think tutorials would help like in a college
setting? Yeah. So I think for at least at my age, like if you are struggling with a class, like for a lot of kids, they could be like really good, like straight A students and still be an Avid and still be benefiting from it. Like they might get by just doing really good on the tests and using those like really big summative things to bring their grades up to an A. But then like in college, it won't, like, I don't think so at least. You really have to work on all the small assignments because like it's so easy to get through by just like being pretty smart and doing all the tests. And then the real struggle is then having missing assignments. Like at the end of last year, I ended up with like 20 something missing assignments. It was pretty bad. And then this year it's like, I don't think I've had one for more than like a few days. I think I had one for like a couple days. Okay. I turned it in after.
Just should have said no in Carson.
Yeah.
You would have been excellent.
But then, so like for the kids that really just are trying and just don't really know the best way to be doing it successfully and like really don't even do that good on the test and struggle with actually, like they could be having no missing assignments and still have a pretty bad grade. That's when the TRFs are kind of helpful because then you really are working on content, and that might be more helpful for college in my opinion, because then if you don't really have other people or as many people to help, like if you have a couple people that you can kind of work with, you get a lot of other opinions, and it's just a lot more helpful than just like asking one of my friends like, oh, do you have the answer, something like that, because then on the test you could still be doing successful, and then even on the small assignments you're getting like good scores, and then like not having missing assignments, and especially for me, like now that I've started doing the assignments, I'm doing even better on the tests because it's like all the assignments. So yeah, like just, it's almost like just a lot of practice. And then on the tests, if you're able to do really good on those, then like you don't really have as many worries. Like even if you do mess up a little bit on the smaller assignments, it's not like a huge deal to mess up on them. And you still have like kind of a cushion. Like if I get like a 80% on a small assignment, it's like all those tests that I've been doing good on are there to like keep me from getting a like bad grade. I mean, like the chances you like failing a class are like really low though. So like some effort and you're all right.
Okay, all right, cool. Thank you. Thanks. Right, so I try to tell them how tutorials can actually be represented in a college kind of setting would be in like a study group, right? Kids can't go to a professor when you walk into a chemistry class and there's 400 kids. So you're going to mean very little in that kind of atmosphere. And so it's about finding a study group and being, right? Sometimes you're the leader and sometimes you have to, as Carson said, like be the point of excellence versus a point of confusion. And in both cases, you're still learning. And so it is a very different way than kids are not used to. And would you agree that tutorials at first kind of like meh, and then now you're starting to see a little bit more, right, with experience? And so again, once we built that foundation, whether it be focus notes or the tutorials, it took kids time to actually kind of roll with it and see how it could be beneficial. And those are just some pictures of us in our tutorial sessions. Organization. Who wants to talk about organization? You did on the video, that's right. At the end of this, right, or Olivia, could you show us your binder? So a piece of Avid is having a binder, right, because that is what, like, again, the research backs it, that this form of organization, and Olivia really loves this, you know, you can see, she's really quite the binder. Quite the binder girl, yeah, she's got it. But it is a way, and again, for some of them, it was very difficult to adjust to that way of doing things because that's not how it's been. It's been a folder with everything jammed in there, and or there's their backpacks, right? Can you, maybe some of you can relate to what that looks like or feels like. And so this is, again, a way to keep everything for all classes in one place. And then also all work that's returned can then be reviewed before tests, quizzes, or exams. Focus notes. So again, we've kind of talked about this a little bit, but the point in focus notes, again, that Cornell style that we never really were taught, but now Avid really focuses on teaching that. And here's kind of the methodology behind it as to why kids should learn this way of taking notes.
Did you know that the brain is designed to forget things, which makes learning new information really hard? The focused note-taking process makes learning stick. A landmark study done in the 1880s found that people forget along a predictable curve. In an hour, you will forget more than half of what you've learned. A day later, you will only remember a third. And it just keeps getting worse from there. The focused note-taking process is designed to help you remember what you learned. The secret is repetition. Interacting with your notes within 18 minutes will boost your recall from 55% to 100%. Revisiting your notes within one day increases your learning from 70% back to 100%. Notice the curve of forgetting changes dramatically after every interaction with your notes. Complete 5 repetitions, and the information is all but cemented in your brain.
So again, that is one of the big building blocks in Avid is teaching kids how to do focus notes. And I would argue that we are by no means at perfection when it comes to focus notes. That's gonna take some time, and it's gonna take some time for students to actually see that value. And so I would expect that after a couple years of doing this process and then and feeling more comfortable with it and seeing that payoff, that's when it's really gonna start to, right? Because again, this is a difficult way to all of a sudden just transition to, now you have to take notes in all of your classes, you know, and we don't take them in all of our classes, but we like to say what at least 3 sets is about, 3 to 5, is about the kind of where we're at right now in the process of learning how to do this particular style of notes. And reading, Ruby. Will you talk to us a little bit about reading and especially the different strategies that we've been working on this year?
So
At the beginning of the second semester, we started reading a novel, but before we decided to do that, we used one of our skills, which was pre-reading it, because that could give us a better understanding of what the text could possibly be about and what we should look for, I guess. And then while we were reading, we've started underlining the text and circling important information. And you can really determine what underlining or circling means to you. But for us, we've been circling key terms, like new characters and stuff like that, and underlining figurative language. Because if you're underlining your text and circling it, it does keep you more engaged because it forces you to think about the text and actually pay attention. Whether just reading it and listening, you kind of doze off and don't really pay attention. So this pre-reading skills and marking the text really helps you retain the information and understand exactly what you're looking for, which can be helpful later on in college because you're going to be getting big textbooks and you're going to have to retain the majority of that information in order to pass the course. Isn't the reading always going to be really exciting? And the reading isn't exactly going to be exciting. It's probably going to be really boring, but you kind of have to do it.
Thank you, Ruby. My clicker starts clicking. All right. And I think one of the big concerns as an incoming, right, as Mr. Curtis also touched on, is schedule. And what does that mean? And so I've had a few people reach out and say, well, does it mean that my son or daughter has to give something up? Well, it could mean that. But I like to think, and that we have a variety of different experiences up here with a different workload and weight load and course load, I should say. But it does tend to fit. And that's something that if you have more specific questions at the end and we open it up, please feel free to ask. But Ruby, you are kind of one of a good example of kind of doing things beyond even what's right here. Can you explain how that fits in, how Avid fits in your schedule and things like that?
So last year when I put in my courses, I originally wanted to take the only AP course that's offered to freshmen, and then I was going to pair that with gym and ceramics. But then when I took Avid, I realized that I also took band with that, and band and Avid are only offered at one time period. So what I did is I discussed with my counselor other class options I could take. I did end up giving up the AP course, but I took biomedical science, which I have learned it's actually my favorite course I take now, and it's probably my favorite, but there is a way to fit things in. Sometimes you do have to give up courses you want to do, but you always can take them next year. You always can take different ones, and you never know. You might take something that you thought you weren't going to like and you just wanted a credit, and it ends up being your favorite class, because I didn't want to take biomedical science at all. I just didn't want to study hall, and it's my favorite course I take now. So there is a way to get Avid into your schedule, and there is a way to still, for me at least, there was a way to still take band and Avid. You just have to work with your counselor and you just have to be patient in order to figure out courses that you can take that will fit in your schedule.
And then, actually, Lisa, I'd like you to just kind of talk about your experience because you are our junior, upper class person. So if you could just tell us just about your experience and why you were interested in it, because it is a little bit different than, some of our other.
Yeah, so I'm a junior this year, obviously. And last year was our first year of Avid, so I guess you could say we were the guinea pigs. And so at first I remember Miss Regan requesting us to go into a little closet classroom, and it was me and a few of my grade level students, and she explained to us what Avid was and what it meant and what we had to do. And at first everyone didn't know what to think. Everyone was like, do we do it or not? And so I committed to it because I thought that it could definitely help me in the future years, and it does. And I just thought that at first it wasn't worth it, but now it is because I'm a junior and I'm going to be a senior next year, which means I need to start planning college life. And Miss Regan has helped us because we have taken college tours, and we've just been researching a bunch of colleges to go to and things that we're interested in. And yeah.
Thank you. Lastly, I'll kind of open it up after this to any questions that you have, either for the students up here or for me or our counselors. But if it is something that you're interested in, this is a process, right? Not everyone is accepted into the program because it doesn't fit the needs of every kid. So there is an application process. The application is in the folder. And then once we would do that, we would do your student interview. And all of you, how was the interview? Was it bad?
I showed up sweaty because I had gym before, and it didn't affect it, so.
Right. That gym class did not knock him out. That was good. Right. Thanks for keeping it real. And so that would be the student interviews, and we would come to students. So even if you're in a parochial or a private school, we can make some arrangements that way to do a Zoom interview. We're very accommodating that way, but otherwise the interviews would take place on campus of Nature Hill or Silver Lake, depending upon that and how many kids apply. So if you have any further questions, please, you know, feel free now to ask, or if you want to have, you know, your some other feedback from them, that would be great. Yeah. So for next year, we're looking at about 30, assuming that we get, right? And so it just depends, too, on our numbers. I don't know that we're hard and fast stuck on that, but that's kind of what we're hoping to have two sections. Yes. It's a good question. So this year we've kind of, right, had different circumstances because of it. But typically going in as a freshman, you sign a contract. And the contract is for a four-year commitment. Because again, that's what looks good on your transcript. And so we haven't even talked about how, especially our local and our, you know, Wisconsin universities look so highly on being an AVID student, because it says, I invested, I committed, I stuck it out. And so really schools are, you know, looking at that on a transcript. So it's tough to say, like, as a sophomore, how you would come in and know about focus notes and things like that. We're always going to make exceptions and do things, you know, for what's best for kids. But I do like to say that really that starting point now is where you're getting that foundation. And these kids are going to only be elevated every year as we continue. So we do like to see those skills being met and strategies being learned at that freshman year. Great question, though. Any other questions or?
Amy, can I add to that?
Yeah. So, you got to come out here. You got to get in the zone.
So I'm Susan Verhagen. I'm one of the counselors at the high school, and I also help with AVID. And I would say freshman year is a big year. It's transitioning to a new building, new people, new teachers. I have two in college, and I think back to their freshman year, finding a niche, whether it's a sport, a club, you know, that just helps you feel part of the high school. And I feel like AVID provides that too. It gives them a niche. It gives them people to kind of start their journey with. So I think in that way, it's a positive thing too for freshmen to start that year. The studying and the classes in high school, there's more expectations there, and having those skills only helps them to start their freshman year. So I would just add to that, I think that niche that AVID provides is another bonus to starting their freshman year.
Any other questions, or did you guys want to add anything? I feel like you all had a chance. Yeah, go ahead, Ruby.
Well, one thing I would say about AVID is I personally, when I joined the program at first, I hated it. I wanted nothing to do with it. I actually really wanted to drop the course. I didn't like anything we were doing. I thought taking focus notes was genuinely pointless. I didn't think that I was gaining anything from the program, but I stuck it out. And now in the second semester, one of my grades isn't an A. All my other grades are straight A's because of the fact that I've taken focus notes, and I actually can go back before my test and I actually can look at the notes and I can actually study off of them. So one thing I would say is don't go into it expecting it to be like really easy and really fun, because at first it's really not fun because you have to learn a lot of new stuff, but in the end you do end up gaining a lot out of it, and I do think it's worth it, but I'm just going to be honest, it's really not that fun at first from my experience.
That's okay. I would you know, make the point that nothing that you learn at first is all that fun, right? If you learn a new anything, a new hobby, it's never good until you get good at it, right? And so I think that's why all of you can say, right, that second semester is a lot different, right? It feels different because they're getting better at it, and it's not so new and difficult. And so, you know, I appreciate your honesty, because we had kids last year from Brookfield Central that said the same thing. Freshman year, I hated it. I hated that binder. Taking that thing around was nuts. I mean, it was so heavy and it was ridiculous. But now I actually love it, and I love to organize it. And right, and those were seniors speaking. And they could see that studying for AP tests and how important keeping your stuff is. They could see that. But again, that's not going to happen overnight. And for some of these kids, it's starting to happen now at 6 months in, right? Did you have something to add? Yeah.
Adding to what Ruby said, she did. She said she thought it was busy work in the beginning. And it does feel a lot like busy work, but eventually you'll realize that it does have a point, and it actually is really helpful to learning and in improving your learning in other classes.
I like that Jack said that, because I've been an English teacher for 17 years, and I was always teaching kids how to write or how to read. And now it's neat that I get to teach kids how to learn. And it's across, you know, all skills, and it's for life and college readiness. It's not just so content-based in an English world. And so I like that you're seeing how it helps you to learn. I think that's really key there. Yes?
So do you have multiple grade levels
in the same section? No, not for the nines. And we won't have that after this year was the only year, because we kept the like, Lisa's little group is like the pilot group prior to us actually implementing. So we wanted to give those kids the opportunity to continue. And so they've just kind of, because they still didn't have the focus notes in the same fashion that did a typical kid in the class. So that's why they were still part of it this year, but typically no. So the freshmen are in the Avid 9, the 10s will be in their own section, 11s will be in theirs, and then we'll have a small section of 12s next year as well.
So like 39th
graders. Correct. Yep. Yeah. And so it'll probably be two sections. At least that's what we would be hoping to get. Mm-hmm. Any other questions? Yeah. What? Oh, good question. Yes, it is. It's a full credit because it's a year-long skinny. And I'm sorry, what? It does meet every day. Yep. And so tutorials are on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And we hire tutors that typically are current college students or adults in the community that can add and mentor these kids. So it's not tutoring that you may think of like a content area tutor, like I need a tutor in math or I need a tutor in English or my writing. It's not a tutor that way. The tutor is really an academic facilitator. So someone who works with these kids to make sure that they're asking good high level questions. And so that's how the tutorials are run by our tutors, which really are kind of like mentors who have just either come out of college or can speak to that experience as well. Good. Yeah.
All right, so kind of on what Jack said about like the don't go into it thinking like that it'll be easy, because like you might not think that everything is benefiting. Like for me, I don't necessarily like taking notes as much, but like that's just, it doesn't seem to like benefit for me, but like everyone's different, you know. Like I like asking questions and helping the other kids while we're doing TRFs, but then there's some things like the TRFs for like other kids, it is just like they need to learn. And then for some kids, notes, like they just have a hard time remembering the things that they learn, so a lot of that is just trying to benefit them. And like I guess one thing is like I kind of went into it thinking that like it wouldn't be like, I figured that it would be like a little bit more, because they had said like you have to be ready to like kind of push yourself. But like I think the first semester really was harder, but I think that was just getting that initial kind of like really, I think for me it was like making sure that like you get that work ethic for high school in first. And I think for the second semester so far, it's been like, at least right now, it's like kind of coasting off of that, but I'm sure it's going to be harder again. And I think it's like, as long as you go into the mindset, like being prepared to do a lot of work and not thinking that it's going to be some like kind of just you get a credit and then you like pick up some help from it. I think that really is like you need to be ready to be taking in a lot of more knowledge about what just how to do better in school and being able to like use that like consistently throughout all your classes.
Sure. So I can't stop. The focus notes are, they are like routine and they are like, you should do this, but it's not like you have to do this and you have to write everything down, paraphrase exactly this. It's kind of unique to the student and how they best learn and how they best comprehend the stuff that the teacher is teaching you. So it's not like set in stone, this is what you have to do for your focus notes. It's kind of, you adapt and learn to take focus notes your own way, but you still follow all the process of taking them, like highlighting, going back, writing a summary, and like kind of annotating on them so you look back at them.
Excellent. Thank you. That was so well said. Ah, you're impressive today. You're on. Yeah. All right. Any other final questions? Please feel free to email me or give me a call. I'm willing to talk to you or meet with you again if you need any things clarified. But thank you very much for coming, and we'll be around if you want to take a look at their binders. Or Jason, do you have anything to say?
No.
Okay. Oh, sure.
Scheduling is kind of an enigma to people who are new like us.
Yeah.
I don't understand how you determine what TFC should fit.
I can explain that.
Susan, too, our counselor.
So what,